What's up, guys? What's up? Welcome back. This is Dibalen Football Channel, Kaizer Chiefs Football Channel. You know what it is. Today, I'm very much excited. We're going to speak about just one thing. Kaizer Chiefs versus Mamelodi Sundowns, a game that is going to take place tomorrow, 24th of October. Kickoff is on half past three. Very first game of the season. It's going to be very interesting. We start in the first game of the season, number one and number two of previous season are already, you know, facing each other. So I think it's a very interesting one. Mamelodi Sundowns is a very strong team. Must not undermine it or read anything from the, you know, the results against Bloemfontein Celtics. It's a cup game against Bloemfontein Celtics, and therefore cup games are unpredictable, you know. So you can't read anything. You can't read much from the cup game. There's nothing much to read on it. We must look at it as it is and not undermine the fact that Sundowns is still a very big team. Very strong one. They have not lost any player. They're still very strong. So one thing that I want to mention before we start with the preview is that I want to thank you guys. I want to thank you guys for what you've been doing, for the support that you've been giving me. We're now at 45 subscribers, and this is just video number 8 of the channel. Video number 8, 45 subscribers. To me, that shows progress. That shows progress. And I don't know to you, but to me, it shows progress. And our views are increasing. I think daily, I can see there's a huge difference between when we started and right now. So I appreciate the support. Let us subscribe. Let us like. Let us turn on the notification button and let us share. Likes are very important. They promote the video. When people are searching, they make it easy for our video to appear in their suggestions. So it's very much important. Let us like, let us subscribe, and let us share. And speaking about the game, before we speak about game, let's speak about the PSL Awards. We congratulate all players that won. Unfortunately, Kaizer Chiefs players didn't win anything. And there are parts where I'm not satisfied, to be honest. There's few awards that I'm not satisfied with. But, you know, it's all done. You can't cry over spilled milk. We can't do that. We'll move forward. Just ourselves move forward. That's how we are, and that should be the attitude. I'm not satisfied with the Defender of the Season award. I'm not satisfied, not convinced at all. I'm not satisfied with the Goalkeeper of the Season award. I know that people are going to speak about clean sheets, but as I said, clean sheets have to do with not only the keeper. There's also defense that is involved, and how the team is able to be organized and defend, and the teams, how it approaches other teams. So I think SuperSport did one of the great defensive, you know, strategies or defending players, and they were very organized, to be honest. But if they feel that Williams deserves it over Akpei, then it's fine, it's not a problem. We move forward. Goal of Manyama and Kekan, well, to me, either way, it could have went either way. You give to Manyama the goal of the season, still I'm okay. You give it to Kekan, still a very great goal. Anyway, congratulations to everyone who has won, all the players. Temazane deserves it. Temazane deserves everything that is coming his way. I mean, the guy did very well, man. Last season, you can't fault him on anything. It was so perfect. To me, it's been a long time seeing a player that works harder than him, that is so smart like him. He's very slow in terms of pace, he's not so fast, but you find him in boxes, you find him in dangerous places. He makes either a dangerous move into the box, or the pass that he passes, it's just so focused and determined. He's a very wise player, very clever player. I think he's one of the players that you know, in South Africa should appreciate. Tembazwane, big ups. It's coming from a Kaizer Chiefs fan, of course, But let's hear it. I think our lineup should be this way. We should have Kune as our keeper, no doubts about it. I hope he doesn't do what he did to Musiamir. We don't take those things very lightly. We take them very serious. And on the right, hope Frostler is going to play. Frostler was responsible for the goal against Maritzburg United. Was very responsible. Makes a pass inside the middle of the pitch. You pass a midfielder and you are not sure. You can't do that. I mean, that's a mistake that is done by kids. It's done by primary school kids that are still learning football. You don't pass ball inside the pitch and it doesn't arrive because when it's won, when you win that ball, it just exposes the defense. But I think it's gonna start with Ramashwam Phahlela obviously, and Cardoso, and then Sassman on the left. I think the defense should stay as it is, just to speak on issues of confidence, and Matou is not back as well. But the defense, for a defense to be strong, you need to show confidence on them. So I think if we repeat them, play as they are, I think we're going to do fine just at the back. And if our right back and left back are not moving forward a lot, we won't have problems. Now that Katsane is back, Manyama is back, I think we're going to have changes in the midfield as well. The first thing that I'm sure of is that we won't have Antoine Akum in the middle of the park. Won't have him. I'm very sure of that. And I don't think there can be any mistake. Katsane back, Ngobo back, there's no need for Akum. There's no need for Akum at all. I don't think we even need him in the bench. You know, I don't think we even need him in the bench. But anyway, I think this is how we need to line up in the middle of the park. We need to play Katsane as CDM. We need to play on the right of Katsane, we need to play, you know, Bakas. On the left of Katsane, we need to play Ngobo. Because in the Pile Ngobo. And the battle is going to be in the midfield. This is Mamelodi Sundowns. I think the battle is going to be in the midfield. And we need Katsane. Instead of Bloem, we need Katsande. Because we can't have two inexperienced players. We're going to have Bloem and Ngobo inside in the middle of the park. We're going to face one of the best midfielders in the country, you know. There's Jali, there's Ricardo Kotze, Captain Kekana. You know what I'm talking about. Themba Zwane as well in the middle of the park. So I don't think Kosindiphile Ngobo and Bloem can be paired together in that game. I just think it will be irresponsible for the coach. It will be exposing youngsters to a very, very strong midfield of champions of PSL. It won't work. So Katsane should be back with his experience, with his, you know, energy and with his leadership. He needs to be back. He needs to work with Ngobo, work with Bakas. And Bakas, what I like about him is that he moves, he likes drifting towards the right side of the pitch as a winger, and he assists Frostler as well on that side. So that's very good. We're going to need someone as a winger, because we don't need someone Frostler to be going forward a lot. As he said, as the coach said, that he prefers his full backs to be standing, not moving forward as wingers. He doesn't believe in that. He wants full backs, right back and left back, to be the old right back and left back, to stick in their positions and to do their defensive work. So I think Bakas, when drifting on the right, is going to be very good. And Ngobo playing and assisting Katsande and making sure that there's a connection between the midfield and the strikers. That is what I think should happen. In the forward, I think they should play Billiard on the right and Parker on the left. And in the front, there should be, you know, Castro. Leonardo Castro is back, fit. We saw how he changed the game. I think Parker is going to be very crucial in this game as well, with his experience, with his energy, and the fact that he arrives in the box. What is nice about him is that he's very versatile, can play assisting the midfield, he can mark, he can hold up the ball, he can pass, and also he can arrive in the box and can assist in the box. So I think we're going to need his energy, more especially in the first half of the game. We're going to need him. So I think Parker should play assisting the striker of Castro and Billiard. And Billiard, obviously, starting on the left or on the right, but drifting just next to Castro. It's very much important. So outside, now that we're done with our first 11, Kune, Frostler, Rama, Cardoso, Sassman, Bakas, Katsande, Ngobo, Billiard, Parker and Castro, I think outside we should have Moleko, should have Ntshangase is back. Ntshangase is back as well. He can come in from the bench. You'll be a very good, you know, asset from the bench. Can have Manyama as well, who's back as well. I don't think he should start this game as well. I think we should give some confidence to Ngobo, give some confidence to Bakas as well, so that they are able to know that they're part of the team and they can gain confidence, can put up that competition. We know, no doubt, Manyama is our first team player, well experienced. Should be outside. They should be Ngezana outside. Moleko must be outside. Bruce Buvuma outside. And one interesting player that should that was on the bench that I think should be on the bench again and should come in, should be given a chance to come in, is Lesako. Lesako, they were playing together with Blom and Ngobo in the MDC. If you watch Lesako, if you watch Kaizer Chiefs, in fact, you watch Kaizer Chiefs in the development division, you will see that Lesako is a very good player. So I'm hoping that he should be given some chance as well. Like Happy was given a chance, I think Lesako must be given a chance as well towards the end of the game, just to get some minutes of the game. Because young players are going to be very crucial. If you can't sign players, young players are going to be very crucial. They are going to be very crucial. Bruce is going to be, you know, the second keeper. I don't have a problem with that. And I hope Akpe's issue is being fixed. Because there's now issues around Kune's name, and we don't want to run out of options. I hope Akpe's issue is being fixed. And now that we're done with the lineup and the people, the players outside, what I think should happen is that if we play well in the first half, if we play well, we manage to contain Mamelodi Sundowns in the first half, we don't concede goals. If we don't concede goals in the first half, it's going to work on our advantage. First, we need confidence. Defense needs confidence. And the defenders, the more they stay without conceding, the more they play game time without conceding, it speaks a lot on their confidence. And I'm a fan of the defensive work of the game. I like the defensive work of the game. It has to be perfect for everyone to win games. I mean, you can score as much as you want, but you need to defend. You need to defend very well. You need to defend very well. Part of the things that costed us last season, we gave away simple goals. I think we gave away simple goals, crosses, simple goals last season, and players were not that confident. And I think if we defend well in the beginning of the half, second half, then we can be, you know, more forward looking and looking to ahead the opposition. But anyway, I think the game will end. My score prediction is, I think Kaizer Chiefs and Mamelodi Sundowns score prediction. We expect Kaizer Chiefs to win this one. I expect Kaizer Chiefs to win this one. And I hope we win this one by score 2-0. Expect Kaizer Chiefs to win this game 2-0. I think once we fix our defense, scoring won't be a problem against Mamelodi Sundowns. Last season we played against them. Yes, we won the first game, we lost the second game, but I don't think it would be a problem scoring against them. We'll fix our defense, we can win this game 2-0. Well, you can tell me what's your prediction, score prediction. You can also tell me about your lineup, what you prefer in the lineup. Otherwise, that is all from me. Thank you very much, guys. Thank you.